I welcome you to the Stanley Town Full Council meeting. May I take apologies for absence, please?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. We've received apologies from Councillor Kane and Councillor Davidson, who are both on holiday, because it's our turn, and Councillor Armstrong is not here.
You are okay, madam? Members, okay? Declaration of interest. Would members please declare? Any declaration of interest, please? No declarations of interest? Okay. We come to item three, which is appropriate announcement for the town mayor. I just want to say that we will be having an annual OAP's dinner, which will be funded from the mayor's budget. The date will be sent by email to all members so that all members can invite their OAPs, and the town clerk will send out the email informing them of the exact date. Is that okay?
I mean, the event will be held in the daytime, like it was last year, but not this year. Quite well received, actually.
It was December was good.
Right. Okay, well, we'll confirm that on email with us. We'll get a ticket to you guys.
In that email, will we also put how many members we can invite from our areas?
Will do, yeah. Oh, just the usual. Obviously, we are recording the meeting. There's also a member of the public recording the meeting. Is anyone else recording the meeting? Right, Councillor Wilkinson is also recording the meeting. Just be aware that you are being recorded. If you're a member of the public, what you say will be picked up on there, although you probably won't be picked up on the camera.
Okay. We go on to number four, which is public participation. The town clerk has something to say here.
I have one question which was received in advance. You don't mind, I'll sit because standing up and holding the computer up. It's received from Ron Harrison, and his question was, bearing in mind the categorical statement in the election pledges made by the majority party and your own statements at the AGM that no initial expenditure was to be made on any regalia, how would the council justify the proposal, even if the cost is not high, of the provision of a relevant chain for the mayor's partner, the deputy mayor, and presumably if he had a partner, his partner also? In addition, in view of the tradition which has been started to remember today, eventually on such a city, is this to continue? Will the mayor attend? And will he continue to upset residents in Anfield Plain while wearing a white pocket the side of the conscientious objector? Now, I've already responded to this, and I'll read the response for the benefit of members of the public that are here. Dear Ron, thank you for your message. In relation to your question concerning civic regalia, you have, I believe, taken comments made by myself on Facebook out of context. When the matter of the silent chairman was placed on the agenda for the annual meeting of council, there were a number of people making comments on the town council's Facebook page to the effect that having a town mayor as opposed to a chairman would cost lots of money. My statement that changing the style to town mayor of itself would cost the council nothing was true, and indeed the change of style to mayor has resulted in no additional expenditure in the current year to date. What has happened subsequently is the council has asked me to investigate what the cost would be of a badge to be worn by the deputy town mayor. No decision has been made to commit any expenditure at this stage, therefore I cannot justify a decision that the council has not made in respect of expenditure. The second response was to confirm the laying of the wreath at the civic hall, which will take place on Friday the 10th of November at 11 a.m. So that's the date for the diary. We normally have a little ceremony here on the 11th. The 11th falls the day before the Sunday, so it's going to be on the Friday this year outside here. And the third question, the white poppy is a symbol of pacifism, which, as I understand it, was first distributed by the Cooperative Women's Guild in 1933. The Peace Pledge Union from 1934 and is supported by the Anglican Pacifist Fellowship, prominent members of which were opposed to carpet bombing of German cities in World War II, and whose leadership were early forerunners of this campaign for nuclear disarmament. I do not know whether the town mayor intends to wear a white poppy this year's remembrance ceremonies. It's a matter for him. Those other responses and in writing.
Okay. Can I have a look at the public there, please? Billy, there's only one thing I want to say before we start. Unless it has something to do with the agenda.
It is.
Okay, that's fine.
I'd like to speak on item number 11 on the agenda. This is both a question and a comment. On the DCC website, I read the County Council applauding itself in helping the Shoulder and the Railway Museum in regards to its future and its repair needs. DC said that they were giving the museum over to another group free of charge, and that was before that, as part of it as a listed building, the repair costs would be borne by the county. This being so, could not our county councillors make a coordinated effort with the town council to say that the county, that was what is good enough for Shildon, is also good enough for Stanley? Or does DCC think that this part of the county is not as deserving? I'd like to pass this over to the minister. Thank you very much.
That's a rhetorical question for the county council, and we can't obviously answer.
Yes, but
it's on record.
What I'm asking is, can't our councillors, as a whole, as town councillors and county councillors, make a concerted effort, knowing that it's what has happened in Shildon?
Well, I think that the item is on the agenda, and it will be discussed when it comes up.
Thank you very much.
Are there any other questions from the public?
No. I'm going to item 5, which is the confirmation of council minutes, to approve the correct record and sign the minutes of the following meeting on the 26th of September 2017. Is that approved?
Yeah. I think back to the minutes, there was no account of your official statements about the election in the following discussion. And I think that should be one of the issues.
It's a matter for council. Our minutes generally are decision minutes. Obviously, we record questions from the public and the responses, because that's why the public come. We don't normally minute discussions that take place beyond the decisions that are made. Obviously, we have a recording of the entire meeting. If council wants extra bits to be put back into the minutes, then we can do so. But bear in mind that we've always had decision minutes. When do we, as officers, know that it's not decision minutes, that we should be putting in a bit of commentary or a comment made by an individual member? So it becomes a bit difficult for us to actually pull the minutes together. However, if it's a council decision whether it goes in or not.
With a statement, according to the decision, as such as a statement. No.
That's why it's not in. That's.
Yes, Mr. Mayor, I just moved that we accept the minutes that have been presented as a true record of the meeting.
I second that.
Of hands, both. Those that agree the minutes should be approved. And against? Okay. That's carried.
I don't want to make points here, but surely if someone's going to object to some minutes, they should be offering an alternative to a minute and have something written in. And I noticed that the opposition all agreed on that, they all voted that the minutes weren't the correct record. Now, it's been agreed by this council there are a true record, so it would have been helpful to know there what they wanted in and where, and the point that's been made there, but nothing written down. So we've accepted the minutes.
We've accepted the minutes.
Anyone else who wants to make a point on that? No. Now, now to received the minutes of the Finance and Governance Committee meeting on the 11th of October 2017. As attachment B. Shall we just receive it? Item 7 now, the recommendations of the committee meetings. Since we only have the Finance Committee meeting, there are these recommendations. There are two recommendations down there. The first one is on public participation in meetings. Are there any comments on that one?
There is a report which has been circulated as attachment C, which hopefully members have had the opportunity to read. And this is proposing that we make some changes to the way we manage public participation in meetings. On page 2 of the report, they are outlined. The first is to require questions to be notified in writing in advance of the meeting. Putting criteria in place which give the council the opportunity to deny malicious, frivolous or irrelevant matters being raised. Put criteria in place to prevent the same issues being raised time and time again. Give the chairman more power to require people who cause disruption to leave the meeting. And to take steps to ensure the public are provided with information about the range of ways that they can interact with the council and the councillors outside of just coming to the meetings and involving the public participation. And I've given some examples from other town councils. I used Siren Sister. There were a number of others, but Siren Sister had a good worked example on the website. I've attached their website piece on how to participate in meetings and also an extract from their standing orders, which the Finance Committee's recommendation was that we adopt that for ourselves. In respect of item 4 on this, of giving the chairman more power to require people to cause disruption to leave, our current standing orders, which are standard standing orders, if someone is being disruptive in a meeting for any reason, require that there's a motion from the floor to exclude someone. To strengthen that, really, we'll just give the chairman more discretion if someone's being disruptive to actually make that decision for himself. And that is, you know, that's in place in a number of areas. And the other ones, I think, are self-explanatory. So, unless there's any questions on that.
The second one was on Mayor's announcements. That at the full council meeting, rather than have just mayor's announcements, that there should be a verbal report by the mayor for what the mayor has done during the period from the last meeting. In addition to that, quarterly verbal reports from representatives to outside bodies like the AAP, CDAP, and FACT, etc., will also make regular reports so that members are made aware of whatever is happening with all the other groups that are present. So if it is agreed, then from next month onwards, there will be a mayor's announcement. Okay, you're moving it. Any seconders? Seconders there. Can I have a show of hands, please?
Those are great.
So
ask if anyone disagrees.
Oh, sorry, does anyone disagree? Sorry.
I think we had enough in place to do what
sorry,
we need
Chair,
to do.
Sorry, Chair, can I just say, we finished the debate, we've taken the vote, so it would be helpful if this was said before we took the decision. What's happened is we've taken the decision as a council, that agenda right is now gone as far as I'm concerned. We'll move on, but if you had any objections, you had ample opportunity to raise them in the meeting, Joan, and you didn't.
Sorry, through you, Chief. You went straight from leave to the next item.
By point of order, Chair, the same applies. The Council took a vote on the agenda item, and we've now moved on to the next part of the agenda. There's ample opportunity before we voted to have a debate on it, and that debate's now passed, and we've got hands up and voted to on the next agenda item.
I'll carry on to the next item, please. Next item is item 8, which is the medium term plan. The recommendation from the Finance and Governance Committee is given over there. There are 4 recommendations.
The medium term plan members have had a copy of this circular as attachment D. It was looked at the Finance Committee meeting. The recommendations are that the Council should adopt the draft medium term plan that the town clerk, in consultation with the chairman of the Finance and Governance Committee, should prepare an outline, 3-year delivery timeline, and indicative budget estimates for delivery of the plan, and these obviously will be delivered back to the Finance Committee and the Council. Budget provisions for the action which are identified for delivery in the next financial year should be inserted to the second budget estimate to be presented to the Finance and Governance Committee for review in November. And once those objectives for 2017-18 have been agreed, the Projects and Initiative Committee should begin working up detailed project plans to sit beneath the medium-term plan for each action to be brought forward to full council for a review.
Any comments on it? Any questions on it?
I just wanted to say that this medium-term plan is going to be one of the keystones of this Stanley Town Council going forward. The plan itself has 9 objectives which are linked to the council pledges that were given, and they cover the areas of regeneration, environmental crime, working with children and young people, a programme of good quality events, support for community facilities and sports clubs, good value for money through an effectively managed Stanley Town Council, application of the living wage, effective communication with the people of Stanley and the surrounding areas, and the feasibility of a heritage facility. And a series of actions sits underneath each of these objectives to deliver against the plan. And I think this is a really good piece of work that has come through the financial and governance group, and I really think that we need to take cognizance of it and support it going forward.
Is that agree?
Through you, Chair, I'm taking a bit of advice, and unfortunately I haven't got the advice that I wanted as yet. So there are a couple of issues that at this point in time I couldn't.
I think at the last Finance and Governance Committee meeting it was said that if anyone had any feelings or questions about what has been written over there, that they could bring it back to the subcommittee. I think any kind of decision making should be taken back to the subcommittee, which they can then make a recommendation, which is then brought back to full council. So, sorry.
Chair, Councillor Nicholson, if you've got any concerns, would you like to express what they are? So
no,
so we know.
No, it's not the
time,
there are things
that I'm taking some advice on. But you could highlight what you think the concerns might be, and Council can debate them.
I need to ask the question first. I'm taking some advice from the
elderly. But if you think there's an issue with it.
It's advice, I'm just taking some independent advice, that's all I'm taking.
So you think there's a problem with the medium term plan, but you're not prepared to share it with
the
Council?
No, I'm saying I'm not sure on something that is in there that I want to check out first.
Right.
I just think it's worth noting that the LGA don't govern town and parish councils across the country. The LGA are responsible for principal authorities. It's the National Association of Local Councils that oversee the governance of town and parish councils. So that's the first point I would make. In terms of us as a council, I think it's important that we have got a longer term plan. And Jeanette's highlighted the areas. I think it's a good plan that the people of Stanley will really appreciate and see some lasting benefits. What this plan actually does is, for the first time since the town council was established, is give us a longer term vision as to how we would like to see improvements for the residents and the community. And I think everything in there, the things that are within the council's gift to deliver, there's nothing in there that legally the town council couldn't provide or couldn't do. So I think that it gives us a really good starting point. What we now need to do is to continue the process that's been started and the good work that Jeanette's picked up through the Finance Committee to now find a budget and then eventually a staffing structure and then to take this forward and start to deliver on some of these priorities, but in a joined up way, so it's not just making policy up on the hoof, but we've got to coordinate plans to what we're going to do and what order, Chair.
Okay, any other comments? Can we say we recommend take the recommendations from the Finance Committee, please?
Could we have someone move them?
Yeah, could we have someone move that, please? And who will second that, please? May I have a show of hands for accepting it, please? Those against?
Abstention? Or abstention?
We go on to item 9, which is the grants and MIP policy. There are three recommendations made over there, and members would have had a chance to look at attachment E. Are there any questions or comments to be made on this, please? May I take it then these recommendations? Can I have a proposal for these recommendations to be accepted?
Yes. Councillor Carmichael, move proposal.
Any seconder, please?
Councillor Carmichael.
Okay, may I have a show of hands on accepting the recommendations, please?
Before we move on, Chairman, can we talk about who's going to be on the working group? The second recommendation is that a grant funding working group should consider the applications in light of the revised policy and the medium term plan. Obviously, the medium term plan and the new policy have been accepted. We still need those councillors to review the applications that have been submitted.
Okay.
Can I suggest that come through the group leaders? Sort out this, please.
The chairman of the committee and the leaders. So that would be chairman of both committees, the chairman of the town mayor, and the leader. Is that your proposal, Councillor Marshall?
I would suggest that the group leaders made recommendations that put forward people for the group for the next week.
Right, okay. And how many in total do you want on the group? Well, I need to be clear, I need to know how many invited to be. Sorry, I don't mean to push it, but I need to know
how many invited to be. How many do we think we need on the group? Is there any recommendations on that?
Chair, I propose there's 7 on the group, and it's made up as a political balance of the overall council, so the percentage which would probably be 5 Labour and 2 Greens and 10 members. I suggest that the group leaders make recommendations to recommend those people who are going to be on the committee will be.
Okay.
Proposal.
That's a proposal. Is there anyone?
Yes.
Agreed?
Yeah.
Is that agreed?
Agreed.
Okay. Item 10 is on the Christmas shutdown for the staff. Offices normally close between Christmas and the New Year, excepting for events that take place in the Civic Hall in line with the practice of Durham County Council. Can I have a proposal that should be that recommendation be carried, please?
Chairman, before this goes, every year we bring this item back. We have to ask for this to be agreed. Could I propose that obviously what we put forward mirrors what Durham County Council will have in place already for their staff? Could we not somehow include this in the constitution that we follow Durham County Council's practice for the Christmas shutdown, and then we can just advise you what the dates are rather than having to come back and ask for it every year? It might simplify things.
Is there any objection to that, please? No objections, so that is carried. Let's carry that. Now we come to item 11, which is the Stanley Town Council offices. There are 3 recommendations given over there. I'm presuming we've all read what the subcommittee have to say over there. Can we have any comments, please, on this? Questions, comments, or anything other than what Billy said earlier on? David?
Yes, Mr. Mayor. I think it's straightforward what we've said in there, that we want to notify the DCC that the Town Council intends to withdraw from the proposed purchase of the building on the current terms. So what Billy's saying really is superfluous from the point of view that we're looking at new ways of doing it, new ways of funding it, and he's preempting what we're going to try and do in any negotiations. So I would just simply move that we accept the 3 recommendations and take it forward from there.
Are there anybody?
Just a quick comment that obviously there's been some expectations raised along the way with this project in terms of the two well-established local community organisations in the Just Women's Centre and Shade. And all that I would say is that I would hope the council would look to continue to work alongside those two charities in realising any ambitions that they have to grow and develop their services here in Stanley, as they're both well-established organisations with a really good record of delivery for our communities.
Right, may I take the first proposal, unless someone's got any additional comments to make on what David Marshall has just said?
There's no comments, does anyone want to move the recommendations or move something else?
Nothing else move? Can I move the recommendation then, please?
Yep. On move it?
David's moved it, second.
I'll second. May I have a show of hands, please, to accept that?
Against.
All against?
Any abstentions? Motion's carried.
Date and time and venue of the next meeting is Tuesday the 28th of November 2017, 6:30 at Stanley Civic Hall. This meeting is now closed.
Just to make you aware, the full council next month will be in the usual committee meeting will be at the venue to be arranged if the show is. So there will be an alternative venue for next month's committees.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.